lovely things on the way.
And I think he's going to be brave enough to probably swim with crocodiles.
Yeah, I reckon it'll be very good for him, as Gus said. You know, get him a little bit more back in action. He's been a bit, let's just say, corrupt into the mind a bit over the last year or so.
I could say he's gonna get fit on his ride, very fit. By a crocodile and all his bones are not crushed, he's going to get his knife out and take their eyes out.
So here I am, Cairns Airport, just about to start my adventure I've been talking about for months. From Cairns to Darwin, 2,500 kilometres along the Savannah Way, along sandy corrugated roads, through river crossings. So many questions. Like, will I find water? Will I be able to carry enough water? What will I eat? What about wild dogs? Pigs and crazy bushmen? Crocodiles? Where will I sleep? Will I have the strength to ride the distance? So many questions. I've been cycling for a few weeks now. I'm feeling strong. I'm in my element on the bike, with the sun on my back, the wind in my face. I feel free. Go. Cup tea time. The rhythm of the day is only broken by my curiosity. Some tracks into the bush. Maybe a good waterhole, or perhaps a nice campsite. Or a chance encounter with another person. I'm really missing my kids. Wish they could see through my eyes. A cup of tea is a good thing. Time to reflect on the day.
What have I become?
I'm scared of what's to come. The distances are so great. The isolation is intense, and the road is just deteriorating day by day.
I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all.
The nights are never much fun. The same food and always the same company. The morning finally arrives. The promise of a new day brings me joy, a smile. I'm learning to be present, to be in the moment. There's so much beauty out here. Now I'm not far from Darwin. My trip's nearly over. I did it. I'm alive.